Hey, Jeff.
Hey, Vinny.
What are you doing today?
I don't know. I was just kind of hanging around, not really doing much of anything.
Well, yeah, we got this game, Deadly Premonition. I was thinking maybe, you know, since we might not play through it on our own time, maybe we should sit here and play through it and record the whole thing.
What?
We would endure the game for a while.
Why would...
People might be
don't
interested.
Don't you remember the last time we did this?
No. Is it? What are you talking about? You mean the 7 months of my life that I can't remember?
All right, fine. I will watch you play Deadly Premonition. And so it begins, Bradley.
Oh, man. What are we doing?
Episode one of our Deadly Premonition Endurance Run. You asked for it, and now you're going to get it.
Well, you've said it out loud. I guess that makes it real.
Yeah, it's kind of crazy.
We're actually doing this.
We're actually doing an endurance run. Oh. Brad and Ryan. Brad's driving, just for the record.
Oh, great. Thanks. Now they know.
Oh, they would have known sooner than later anyways.
Probably
Brad.
Right.
All characters appearing in this work are fictitious, Brad.
Okay.
Just a clears up here.
Clears up any confusion.
Yeah.
Now, I know next to nothing about this game. How
Me
about
too.
You? Not a thing?
I know that people have been drawing a lot of comparisons to Twin Peaks.
Okay.
And I know that this is an incredibly divisive game.
Yeah.
Some people love it for its terribleness, and some people hate it for its terribleness.
Jason?
It's me. You're. If you can hear my voice, could you respond?
I'm not gonna do it.
No, we could.
Good. I thought you wanted to see.
Press A to respond. Answer.
Wait, are we Zach or are we York? You were York before.
It's okay.
Well, you had to answer like you were Zach, right?
That's one way of looking at it. But it's totally wrong.
That cigarette is way too far in his mouth. I'm just gonna say. Yeah.
Listen,
he must be cool.
It's called interdependency, and they both know it.
This guy can multitask like nobody's business.
Nasty, even sadistic things. But that's fine as long as that's what Tom wants.
What?
Think of it. His actions. He's always asking for it. It's his partner's job to fulfill that need, and Jerry knows that.
Tom and Jerry.
Got it.
That's right.
Oh, cat and mouse game.
Well, in the Tom and Jerry show.
Oh, wow. That's totally what they're actually talking about. Awesome.
Ah.
I'd hang up if someone tried to break down Tom and Jerry to me, too.
Listen.
I mean, this is ones with the dog, too, right?
I don't believe the Bureau still can't get me a satellite phone.
Yeah. Network.
I thought they said not work.
These puppies are making me go to another town in the boondocks again.
Is that?
I'll be a happy cat.
Sunflower seeds?
That's being a waste of time. At the very least, it'll get me out of
Hash.
The city for a while. Right, Zach?
Who are you talking to?
A cigarette.
The perpetrator from the last case really was something.
Right, Zach?
Who'd have thought there'd be razors laced into your nails?
He.
Crazy.
So.
Crazy.
All right.
Well, at least I now have a scar to show off.
Oh, okay, all right. So he got attacked by someone with razors in their nails. I was going to say, if the dead body had things under its nails.
I arrested the Catwoman wannabe. Women. They're crazy. Don't you agree, Zach?
I mean, now that you mention it, am I here watching? Am I Zach here watching this?
I'm Zach. Drat. Is that camera under the road?
He's gonna have like another scar, I think.
Keep that cigarette in your mouth. You're like 100s too.
That's no good.
Let's get out of the car. It's going to blow up. Come on, York.
Zach the laptop is getting out of here.
Sorry, Zach didn't make it.
Wonder if these guys are just going to keep coming.
Probably.
Let's get out of here.
Okay. I'm in favor of it. Nope.
Oh, not that way. Invisible wall.
This way.
Let's go over here. Oh, no. Let's keep going.
Whoa. Oh, God.
Come on.
Evade.
Oh, God.
You did not evade.
Oh, dude. That's what I get.
You failed to evade.
That's what I get for looking over and seeing what Drew was doing.
Don't pay attention to Drew. You're the... I
try
Drew.
Oh, God. What? I'm not entirely sure why that didn't work. I'm not quite sure what just happened there.
I'm very sure. You died.
Yeah, but I totally did what it said.
Continue.
I think, I don't know, is this, should we call it for the day?
That's
pick
not
up,
a,
you pick up back here tomorrow.
That's not a bad spot for episode one.
All right.
So they're day one of Brad and Ryan's Deadly Endurance comes to a close. Tune back in tomorrow.
I'm having a deadly premonition here about this game.
I have a deadly premonition that Brad's really going to not enjoy himself.
Oh, it'll be fun.
Tune in tomorrow for more of that.
Welcome to Greenvale. Hey, see, you met some of our locals.
You were very late.
Okay.
Credits.
I didn't think you'd keep me waiting in the rain for so long.
FBI Special Agent Francis York Morgan. Please, just call me York. That's what everyone calls me.
Because that's my name. York.
Agent York?
Good, that's good. Are you the sheriff?
It's insane. Are you just crazy?
No, I'm Deputy Sheriff Emily Wyatt. George, he's the sheriff. He went looking for you, actually.
Guy, glowy eyes, an axe.
Great, that's great.
I see. Terrific.
Awesome. If you don't mind me asking, did you walk all
Yes,
way
I walked on my feet.
My car broke down, that's all.
How do you like our textures?
I don't. If you don't mind, I'm going to glow for a little bit. Is that cool? call me Agent Glow. Glow, just glow.
Definitely worth a trip to the primitive world. By the way, don't mention anything about what happened back there. She'll think you're a psycho.
Yeah, you're totally sane.
Don't want that, do we, Zach?
Not again. Not after what happened.
To Greenvale. I'm the sheriff, George Woodman. Call me George.
Everybody calls me George. That's what people call me, George.
FBI Special Agent Francis York.
This is what I do to people.
Please, just call me York. That's what everyone calls me.
Really? Danny Trejo here is the sheriff.
Could you tell me why the FBI is so interested in a small town homicide?
Dogs!
Let's just say it's a personal interest in killers of young women. I'm always looking for new sample cases to help me with my profile.
I'm a profiler. You can call me York. That's what everyone calls me.
Have cleared this with each other. You can remain in command. You don't have a problem with this, do you?
No. No problem. Just want to set things straight. Our small town has its share of problems.
Is he wearing spurs?
I'm the one fixing them one by one.
See? He's totally the Andrew Dice Clay of smoking techniques.
Whip his arm around.
I need you to understand that.
So I'm going down to this chick's dungeon the other day.
By the way, George, I had a little accident with my car. Could you send someone to take care of it?
Thanks.
Oh, and my clothes and luggage are still inside.
You bring those to my room. Thanks, right. George.
Don't worry.
I'm still in charge,
I'll
right?
My assistant Thomas to take care of it.
Tom? Tom?
Do you need
anything? Is he a cat?
Yeah.
Zach, think about it.
Thanks. That'll be all. Well, then, I think I'll rest up first at the hotel.
And then in your house.
Get a piece of pie.
And I'll
continue
on your investigation.
Don't know how to say that. But, really don't need your help. Unlike some of your corrupt city police officers,
play it by the book.
See this hat?
I hope you'll come to appreciate that, Agent Morgan.
Uh-oh. Oh, what?
Investigation. You just think of this as a vacation. Take it easy. Enjoy the nature here. You don't have to be a tree worshiper to appreciate the wildlife here.
But it helps, right?
You're one of them damn tree worshippers.
The situation. There are no cavemen here. We're as far forward as the Middle Ages.
Okay, so obviously people can't hear him when he's talking to Zach.
No. What?
But he is kind of muttering.
Does this say I love mom?
I think it does.
You'll hear it many times during your stay. It's a beautiful sound. And you'll love it too, I think.
I look forward to hearing it then.
Anything else?
Over all this other deafening cacophony of music.
I don't want to keep talking to this lady. Don't make me do it. Oh, I probably should.
Yes, actually, Polly. Could you tell me about the shops around here?
Shops? Well, there aren't many. It is a small town, after all.
Is there anywhere I can get a fridge magnet that says Greenvale?
The Milk Barn convenience store. The couple who
to the Milk Barn!
Pair. I'm sure you'll get to like them. The A&G Diner is a great place to eat.
There's just the Milk Barn, there's the A&G Diner.
If you want to go to a bar, there are two.
I find any restaurant that is letter and letter.
Galaxy of Terror.
What in the F?
And Sweary gets his own. I hope he's a character in the game.
Oh, man.
I hope the game director made himself in the game.
I'm starting to suspect that this may actually be a work of postmodern genius, but we'll see.
Oh!
Did he just...
No, he's got a solid snake ashtray.
Oh, no.
Just take it easy. I'll bring your coffee out in a moment.
Thank you, Polly. I have to warn you, though, I am very particular about my coffee.
Ah, because we watched Twin Peaks.
I like to whisper sweet nothings to it when nobody else is around. What, was there a coffee thing in Twin Peaks?
That's a very explicit, deliberate Twin Peaks-ism, his love of a good cup of coffee. All right, let's see what he gets out of this cup. See if this one tells him the future! Look with interest.
Look with interest at coffee.
Oh, God. Oh, no. It just skull and crossbone shows up.
Did you see that, Zach? Clear as a crisp spring morning.
What is going on?
Okay.
In what?
The coffee. I knew I could count on it. Never fails.
Oh, God, wow. Stop smiling. Don't ever smile again. Whatever you do. Yeah, great.
Maybe somebody has to...
Oh, right there. Hey, we're supposed to go to the police station, but then we got this sweet cop car and figure, why don't we race? Game start. What?
All right.
What?
Three. Get ready.
Go!
Where are we going? All right. Talk.
All right, you made it through. Oh, left. Spin around.
I gotta go around? Oh gosh.
Take the turn. All right.
Driving. Make a left soon?
Yeah.
Straight. Oh gosh. Left?
Yeah.
Maybe I should pop it into.
Oh, or is this where you're going for your mission? Is this?
No.
Yeah, this is not where you're going at all.
Car mechanics. All right, let's put into this for racing mode. This was not a good idea.
No.
We should have. At least the durability on the car is off now.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Sorry, buddy.
They don't react to your sirens at all.
No.
Oh,
Christ. Real driving.
All right, while you drive, I'm going to go move my real-life car.
Okay, you're going to let me gun this on my own?
Yeah.
Let me mess this up on my own?
Yeah, I'll be right back.
You got it. Hey, Ray, let me tell you a little story about me driving on my own. I don't like driving. Ryan, entertain me. But don't look at the screen. Hi, Ryan.
I'm taking Jeff's microphone.
But you're not looking at the screen.
But I'm neither looking or listening to what's going on the screen. I'm, in fact, standing in front of the screen.
So tell me about Attack of the Killer Tomatoes.
Attack of the Killer Tomatoes or Return of the Killer? You know what? I have never seen any of the Killer Tomato movies in their entirety.
That is your loss.
You know, I've seen some scenes from, I guess, Return.
Uh-huh.
Seemed pretty funny. Seemed campy.
Definitely campy. Like I said, I think George Clooney in,
Yeah, George Clooney is in the second one. I know that for a fact. It's like one of his early, like, young, like, even before Roseanne. Remember when he was on Roseanne?
No, yes?
He was in, like, the first couple of seasons of Roseanne. He was, like, the manager at the plastic...
Oh, okay, yeah, this is before that.
Factory.
Even,
yeah, this is before that, and that was, you know, that was, like, mid-80s. That's, like, 87, 88.
Where are you guys in your little...
I can't tell you that.
Oh, man.
That's not fair.
Doing terrible things while Jeff is away. This is, always have a co-pilot on an endurance run.
Turn left. Turn right. Break.
Oh, God.
Reference your map a lot because this game is mad confusing.
I don't know what I'm doing, but at least I'm almost out of time, which is probably for the best. All
right, Jeff's back. I'm done.
Okay.
See you guys later.
Get out of here. Oh, no.
He didn't look, did he?
No. Oh!
I don't want to look at your crappy game.
Oh! I'm so glad you're back. This is all.
Did you win the race?
This all went terribly. No. I totally did
you
not.
You didn't make it?
No.
Oh. Okay.
All right, Japan.
Yeah.
Pleasure to meet you.
Real subtle
Morgan.
There, thanks.
We've been expecting you. I'm Thomas McLean, the sheriff's assistant.
FBI Special Agent Francis York Morgan.
Just a bunch of words.
It's what everyone else calls me.
Very well then, Agent York.
I believe I owe you a thank you for retrieving my belongings from my car. Thanks.
There it is.
No.
There's the thanks I owe you. Paid in full.
Can I have a look at Anna's file now?
Yes, of course.
Let me just mince over here and get that for you.
I've lost the key to the cabinet where the files are.
Oh, you gotta be kidding me.
Why don't you take a look around while I go look for it?
Okay, let me know when things are ready.
I'm gonna be here talking to myself about Star Wars DVDs.
Zach, Thomas appears to be the kind and sensitive type. Totally at odds with the Monarch.
Ah, yes. Striped squirrel keys? Huh.
I bet those are the keys that Thomas was looking for.
Maybe they are.
Let's go back to Thomas.
All right, Thomas.
Blow your mind with these keys. Hell yeah, I did.
Maybe I did.
You found the key.
I hope this is the right one.
It's weird framing. Boom in the shot. Oh, man. Your cinematographer.
Chipmunk this time, have you?
What?
Sorry. Wrong key.
You gonna make me go hunt more keys?
Chipmunk? This species lives in northern Japan on the island of Hokkaido. They're actually quite a popular pet.
So it isn't even a squirrel.
But we're looking for a southern flying squirrel right now.
Hello. What have we here? Ha!
Flying squirrel.
They did say southern flying squirrel, though, right?
It did. But...
A lot of keychains shaped like small animals in this police station.
Well, like squirrels, specifically. Let's try it, at least. Come on.
Come on. Suspense is killing me.
Your squirrels, do you?
God damn it! Keyholder. Let me just put that into my magic inventory.
Something. Ah! It's a gray squirrel. God damn it.
I'll take it anyways.
Who is losing all their rodent-shaped keychains around here? Long-tailed flying squirrel?
Yep, still the wrong kind of squirrel.
F.
Aha!
Hello.
Ha ha ha!
This looks promising. Kind of. Maybe.
What? God damn it!
Dude, this is not happening.
Oh!
Oh, come on. I don't know where else to look. I think we've been everywhere at this point, right?
Let's just talk to Thomas and try and give him what we have and see.
This is a huge bummer. I hope so. What do we got here? Long-tailed, gray, curvy-tailed. Let's try them all.
You found the key.
No, that's probably not. You'll be able to tell us the differences.
Yes.
Hooray! Oh.
Southern flying squirrel.
Exciting.
Yeah, you know, it was called curvy-tailed flying squirrel, yeah. You ass.
I'll be waiting for you. This is how humans smile.
We've cracked a big case already.
I've stapled her hair to her boobs for your convenience.
I hear you.
My hand? I have a hand.
I have a hand?
This is all...
Hand? Hand?
Skull?
Yeah, she fractured her skull like 6 weeks ago. It's fine.
After she was killed, the direct cause of death was loss of blood from the wound.
I don't think my remixing the audio took effect.
Yeah.
The saxophone will always
win. A
little
loud.
What wound?
Which means...
She's dead.
She was cut up while she was still alive.
Oh, God.
Yes, a sharp knife was used. It was inserted...
Let's allow me to dramatically illustrate.
The excessive loss of blood from her internal organs is what
actually... Oh, God.
And... Hand!
Her nails are clean, and with no skin cells from the attacker. She also doesn't appear to have been bound, nor
she did not scratch the victim. She did not put up a fight.
So suicide is what you're saying.
Yeah.
Usher, please, limit your report to your findings as a doctor. Criminal profiling is my job.
Yo, okay. Whatever.
So much for my reality show, Usher, Criminal Profiler.
Died fully, deeply, painfully aware of what was happening.
But,
Dot, 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 dot.
Tell me, what time did it stop raining on the night Anna was killed?
I don't know.
Just before
Take her cuffs.
Right after the movie on TV ended, so... Around 1 a.m.?
What movie was it?
An American Werewolf in London.
That's like my favorite movie. Zach.
Directed by John Landis.
Oh, God.
1981. So the right
okay.
Anyway.
Thank you.
By the ending song, Blue Moon.
What?
George, would you mind if I examined Anna myself?
If you know what I'm saying.
What more do you hope to find?
Whatever. Her tongue.
I'm sure I mentioned that I have a personal interest in cases like these.
Be a really good spot for her smile.
Yeah. Whoa.
What? I'm putting...
Thinking.
Glasses,
thinking.
Glasses,
John,
glasses,
John
glasses,
Landis.
Glasses. Observe his glasses.
His age isn't immediately apparent, though he can't be told that.
Looks like a trustworthy doctor.
Thinking. Well, American Werewolf in London, that's...
85, John Landis, that doesn't seem right at all.
That's
weird.
What do
you think about the other movie that John Landis made?
Oh, there's really no reason we should talk to him anymore. Aww.
We're doing autopsy on George.
I'm going to have to look down at some point. Where's Emily? She could turn to stone.
Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh.
Womp, 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 womp. Okay.
Stop.
Oh. She's neatly wearing fake fingernails.
Neat! Fake fingernails!
How about her toenails? Yeah! She's got, like, hobbit feet.
She has two legs.
What is
that? Zach.
And his body is lying on the table. Thank
Good
you.
Good stuff.
Go west.
There's a mailbox here.
Beautiful blonde hair. Stunning. Even in death.
She's a lady.
She must have cried before she was murdered. Wow, he's good. The tongue has been removed. Look, ew.
No, I don't want to... I don't want to do that at all.
Can I zoom in?
Good. We didn't have time to draw that part, so...
This looks like it could be important.
Nah.
Just Judging from the impression, she was holding something in her hand, but it was removed around 6 hours after the... Dude, I am... We are hell of good at this.
Yep.
I just said, I think it's hell of, which is weird. This game is getting inside my head. That's it. This is how we find the Ark of the Covenant. Oh.
And... scene.
And it was a sugar donut the entire
time. Oh, she was holding a sugar donut for 6 hours after her death. That's how I want to go.